How you guys doing, Eric here? Today is August 29th, 2015, and it's the 10th anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. So, happy 10th anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. Talking about it all over the news this morning. Their precious, precious Hurricane Katrina that they, in my opinion, was their greatest feat of climate engineering that they ever did so far. Oh, that and Hurricane Sandy. But yeah, I'm pretty damn convinced that these fucking storms are all fucking manufactured, controlled, steered right where the fuck they want them to wreak havoc upon the American people, as they are so fond of doing to us, and their problem action solution fucking paradigm we're living in. But yeah, so happy Hurricane Katrina Day, when they were able to fucking take all that money that people donated, and none of it went to help any of the poor fucking people. Just like the Haiti earthquake and every fucking thing else, you know. Giving money to these assholes is like fucking letting the fox guard the fucking hen house. Fucking scumbags like Bill Clinton and George Bush, they put in charge of these fucking funds. And of course, none of the money goes to help anybody. They loan money to people at interest. That's what goes on. But anyways, yeah, so we're heading towards the end of August here, and September's coming up around the corner. Lots of fucking talk about September this year. The big thing I'm hearing about now is the Shamita. They call it some Jewish fucking thing called the Shamita. Everybody's talking about it. And it's supposedly going to be extra severe this year. They're forecasting a really bad Shemitah this year because apparently God's pissed off at the American people, you know, because we've all turned our backs on God, and, you know, we know what a jealous little prick God is. And if we don't go and worship Him and tithe to Him and can live our lives according to what He write down in His book, He's gonna punish us. And He gets all butt hurt, I guess, you know? A little invisible man in the sky that watches everything we do. Apparently, if He's gonna be extra butt hurt this year in the Shemitah, and it's gonna be hell to pay here on Earth, here in America. Yes, the big day they're talking about is September 23rd is the day. And there's all kinds of fear going on, and all kinds of fucking, everybody's getting prepared, and even I'm stocking up for the shit. You know, we had a little stock market hiccup this week, which I talked about last week was going on, and the stock market ended up finishing up for the week. But early on Monday, it started crashing like the biggest one-day fall in history. And then it started coming back a little bit. But, you know, I think what it is a dress rehearsal. They're just giving us a little sneak peek of what they're going to do this month when they really fucking bring the hammers of hell down on the people, and they're gonna fucking crash everything down and possibly declare martial law and fucking start wars all over the world, and they're gonna blame it all on God and the Chinese. Well, they're gonna blame it on us, the godless American people. And because we don't do what God's been telling us to do, and God's mad at us because we have gay marriage and LGBT and all that. So yeah, that's what's the whole Shamita thing. Everybody's talking about it. Glenn Beck, you know, they all sit there. If you ever listen to the Glenn Beck fucking program, they sit there and giggle and laugh like fucking little school children and make fun of everything, make fun of the American people. Hate that fucking guy so bad. He's having his fucking little rally this weekend. What's he calling it? It's all about how, you know, he talks all about how Planned Parenthood is just like Nazi Germany, basically. And, you know, it's another Holocaust going on, and basically just blames it all on us. But yeah, he's having his rally this week. I think it's in North Carolina. Be interested. I listen to him every day on my way home from work just because there's really nothing else to listen to on the radio. And I just kind of sit there and roll my eyes at all the fucking shit he says. And he has his little fucking cronies on with him. And they all kiss his ass and suck his dick on the air like he's fucking their god or something. It's fucking insane. I hate that guy. Fuck you, Glenn Beck. But yeah, a lot of shit happened last week. There's a stock market thing, and then there was a shooting of two journalists, and that was a fucking big deal. That was a fucking big fucking stink going on about that. There's some gay black guy that used to work with the TV station. Shot him and killed him. If you look at it out, if you ever look into that, see how fucking fake that shooting was. Just like all the rest of them. It's so fucking insane, man. And then the fucking media comes out and just fucking, you know, blasts us with it nonstop for fucking days and days and days of how horrible this shooting was. And it all boils down to, you know, we need to stop crazy people from getting guns. That's what it's all about, man. It's all about taking... Oh, there's a... There's a moose over there. Dingo! Yep, that's a moose, all right. You probably can't see it on the camera, but... You can see a moose over there through the trees. I'm not going to go walk over there towards it because these things are fucking dangerous. But yeah, I've been seeing a lot of moose around here lately. Oh well, they're welcome to be around here. I don't care as long as they don't... Like, there's nothing I can do about it, but... Very dangerous. Oh, that's a bull too. Saw his horns. Gotta be aware of them, that's all, because you just walk right up on them and then they're there because they blend right into the woods. But anyways, yeah, what was I just talking about? Yeah, the gun control, yeah. You know, these people are dead, killed, and before their bodies are even room temperature, they start talking about guns. Her father comes out, her boyfriend comes out, and just ranting and raving about how the guns killed my daughter. It wasn't some psychopath. And then they tie it all in. They tie the whole thing in with the fucking gay LGBT agenda. It's all about divide and conquer and take our guns, man. And it was fake, for one, man. They took all the videos down, but first day or two there was a lot of videos out that showed how fake it was. I mean, the guy fucking opens fire on him point blank range, and you know, the woman runs away screaming after fucking three shots point blank range right at her. She's able to run away screaming, you know. It's fucking ridiculous. Totally fucking ridiculous, man. But yeah, so that happened last week. of course, the fucking Donald Trump puppet show keeps going on. They're really giving that guy all kinds of airplay, you know. He's their boy this year. They won't talk, you know, nobody else gets any airplay in this. Donald Trump's talking about him like Jebby. And the guy from Univision, that was pretty funny. Donald Trump's telling him to shut up and sit down. I didn't call on you. Just sit down. Sound like a fucking gangster with his beady little eyes and his fucking awesome comb-over hairdo. You know? So yeah, Trump is the big story in the turd puppet show. It continues. And I guess Hillary Clinton's been on the news quite a bit this week. All her fucking scandal, and they're calling it any kind of scandal, they have to put it as a gate, right? Email gate or whatever. Benghazi gate. So fucking sick of these fucking turds. You know, and the media just fucking plays right along with everything. You know, whatever's on the media is fucking the gospel truth, man. It's just fucking discouraging, man. There's nothing we can do about it, you know? I'm thinking, what can we do? Maybe everybody show up down in front of all the fucking TV stations and protest, man. But that ain't gonna, and then I think that ain't gonna do no good either. They're just gonna ignore it, and they'll probably fucking bring out the National Guard and arrest everybody. Put us all in FEMA camps. So, but they're the ones that are doing it, you know. If we want to get in, get back at them, we got to fucking strike at the fucking media. But there's just, they got every base covered. They're all prepared for the people standing up. And besides, most of the fucking people are just got their heads buried in sand. They don't want to know what's going on, and they're trained not to, you know. And trained all their lives to fucking ignore what's going on, and it's not cool to be well informed. You just gotta, you know, watch your fucking TV shows, listen to your brainwashing music, and go shopping, and keep your mouth shut, and if you're lucky enough to have any money and a job, be good little fucking consumers. Pay your bills, go to work, and be a good little fucking debt slave. Oh, I'm so sick of the way we live in this fucking world. This fucking bullshit society meant to keep us all running on a wheel like a bunch of rats. And the few on top benefit from the whole fucking thing. And they got their henchmen and their police and their military to make sure it all stays that way. They got us all so fucking brainwashed to believe that's the way it is, and that's just the way it's going to be. And it has to be that way. Because if we don't have law and order, the fucking bad guys will come and kill us all. It's fucking bullshit, man. Humans lived for millions of years on this fucking planet without police and military. And somehow we survived. I mean, even the way things are today, there's still all kinds of crime that goes on. You only hear about the crimes that they want us to hear about, but the cops don't do a fucking thing to stop crime. They just fucking show up after the fact and arrest innocent people, usually. Charge them with something. That's what happened to me. But, yeah, it's pretty fucking disgusting the way we live, man. And you know, I think about, well, what can we do? You know? And I just come to the conclusion that it's really too late to do anything, and there really was nothing we can do ever, man. It's always, we were born into it, and they got so much fucking, you know, so much shit set up to keep things the way they are. To keep things the way that they need them to be, that there's really nothing we can do to stop it. Unfortunately. Yeah, you know, I spent a lot of time thinking about this shit and what we can possibly do to fucking stop this whole fucking thing, you know, and restore sanity into this fucking world. But man, the more I think about it, the more I just come to the conclusion that it's just not a fucking thing we can do, man. It's too late. You know, people are too divided, too conquered, and it's really sad and depressing, you know. And that's the way they want it, man. They want us to be sad and depressed and constantly struggling. And so the Archons can feed off all of our negative energy, man. That's what it was all about, I think. That's why they created these huge fucking populations of people, to create huge amounts of fucking negative energy for these fucking fourth dimensional fucking entities to feed off of, man. It's their food. It's the only fucking thing that makes any sense, man. It's all been done on purpose. They created this whole fucking mega societies just to feed their masters, you know. Now, I don't know, now it's like maybe they found some other way to feed, and they just got to get rid of, or maybe it's just gotten to a point where they don't need that much negative energy anymore, so, or they want the huge amount all at once as they lower the boom down on humanity and just start fucking culling us off, man, by the billions. And that'll create super, super negative energy, like basically like crack for the Archons. Maybe it's been done before in the past. And then they really get a big fucking high of fucking negative energy as most of the population is killed off. And then maybe the cycle will start over again. So yeah, I think that's what's going on, man. Not much I can do about it, man. Think about it and think about it, you know. Talk about it and talk about it, but I really don't see anything gonna stop them. As much as we all talk about stopping it and taking the world back, basically it's all crap, man. It's never gonna happen. So yeah, as we get ready to head into the September month here, this is the big month of that everybody's talking about. September, all the fear is coming to a big fucking head here, and it'll be interesting to see how this month plays out. But we'll be watching and see what happens next week. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys.